Hello, Rodney here with Cleves Tech, and today at the request of many subscribers, I'm going to go over some tips on dealing with bad AI hands in focus, stable diffusion, AI in general. Don't forget to check out my other videos on focus as well. The first big tip to generating great hands is actually a negative prompt that I've discovered. Just put Uncle Jack Kelly into the negative prompt, and you're going to get hand results like this. Okay, I wish that was true, but I do wonder if these AIs have watched too much Always Sunny and it has poisoned the well. One of the reasons why AI has a little bit of difficulty with hands is partially because hands have high detail density and they usually take up a very small part of the image. When the AI generator has fewer pixels to work with, it makes it more difficult for it to really show what the hands are supposed to do. It's the same idea as with their training data. Most of these images, especially for SDXL, were trained on 1024 by 1024 images. So the further back, if you look at actual images of real pictures of those resolution, you'll see a lot of times the hands and things like that are hard. They don't look right in those either a lot of times because it has a hard time showing that detail with only a few pixels. So I think that's one of the big reasons why we get a lot of bad hands, because that's what it sees. Now, one of the biggest things that I suggest when it comes to hands is to avoid them when possible. If there are no hands to fix, then you have made things much easier. Now you might be tempted to put in your prompt hands behind back or something similar, but doing so will actually most likely lead to more chances of the hands, since it'll see the words hands in the prompt as well as back. So it'll most likely show the person's back and their hands. There is another solution that works somewhat well, and that when it comes to hiding the hands. So for example, in this one, I've generated four images of a woman standing on a sidewalk. And as we can see here, every single one of them has her hands visible. Now, we can go ahead and fix the hands if they don't come out right. That's one of our options. The other option is actually, and I have issues with the negative prompt. A lot of times it doesn't work that well. And even in this case, it's not gonna work every time. But I have found if you use a combination of different things in here, a lot of times that can help with the images. You're still gonna get a lot that it doesn't work well. But as we're gonna see here, I've gone ahead and I'm using the same seed, and I'm going to generate four more images. Now I've added into this negative prompt hands on hip, holding, all different ones that have to do with keeping the hands visible. I'll go ahead and generate this now and see if that helps hide the hands. Because that's first case is if you don't need the hands in the image, the best way is going to be to just hide the hands. Well, as we can see here, we now have our results, and compared to the other ones, we have our first two. We can see the hands are in the pocket. The second two still got our hands. So it's not perfect, but using the same seed, this showed that you can try to, and you can get more creative also with your regular prompt and depending on what you put in there. But do remember, if you put the word hands in your regular prompt, even if you tell it you want it behind the back, it sees the word hands and it's more likely gonna show hands. It's the same concept of if you want a full body shot, you could just mention the shoes of a person and it's gonna show that. But if you do have hands and want to achieve the best results, it's also crucial to limit their interaction with other objects and other hands whenever possible. The complexity of the hand's action directly impacts the difficulty of creating convincing hands. So grasping objects such as holding a coffee cup or a sword, or having fingers clasped together, things like that, will be more challenging for the AI to work with. So avoid those as well. If you have just a regular hand that doesn't have any complex interaction, it's a lot easier to fix those than it is to fix something that's not. Now, as far as fixing hands, so you have hands, you need to fix them. That is actually where I find that focus actually does a very good job with the inpainting. Now, there's no perfect solution. You're still gonna have to work at it, trial and error, and keep trying. There is some tools to help with it. It's gonna be a lot harder to do some of these with very complex interactions. So you have to really work at those. But let's go ahead with this one. I'm going to just grab this first image here. I'm going to actually bring it down to the in painting window. I see a lot of people are tempted immediately to go down and do the improved detail and put in a detailed hand. Then they'll mask it off and then they'll go ahead and they're going to hit generate. There's a problem with that though. That doesn't actually fix hands. It'll improve hands, but if the hand is really messed up, it actually will just improve the messed up hand in the sense of it'll still be messed up, but it'll be more clear that it's messed up. So really with this, the improved detail, you already need the hand to have proper basic structure for the most part for it to fix and improve it. So extra fingers or not enough fingers or anything like that, it's not going to fix those. As we can see here, when we're looking at it, it's improving the detail of the hand, but it's still messed up. So don't start off with the improved detail, because it's all honesty, if the hand isn't already structured correctly and just needs to be touched up and improved, you're not going to get the results out of that. And you're just going to keep on over and over and over again, trying to fix something that can't be fixed. The method here, what you want to do is what I would do first here is we're going to skip that. We're going to go down here. We're going to change it to the regular in painting. Make sure I have the hand masked off how I want it. And I always give it a little extra room. That way it has a little more wiggle room on improving and what it can do with the hand. Now, all I'm going to do here is just that. I'm not going to work on both hands. I find it's better just to do one at a time. Okay, so I'm actually going to stop it here because one of these is partially, and this is the thing I'll do a lot of times. I'll find one of them is actually mostly good. So this one I've dragged because looking at it, the thumb is correct. So what I'll do here is I'll clear out what I had before masked. And I'll zoom in. So most of this is actually correct, the actual bottom part of the hand. So what I'll do at this point is I'm going to go ahead and mask that. And at the same time, I'm going to mask this one. Might as well have it trying to fix that hand as well. If it gets fixed, then we can go from there. So let's go ahead. And now that I've gotten that part done, I'm still sticking with the regular in paint or out paint because those, I still don't feel confident enough that the improved detail will fix that. Okay, so I'm going to actually now stop that because I find that that image is pretty good. So at this point, I'll clear off this again. Now, let's look at that closer. Just to get an idea. So that one, it's pretty decent at this point. I'm gonna use the improved detail. This one still needs work, so I would continue on that one. But let's, for this to demonstrate, I'm gonna now improve the detail on that other hand that we first did. So now I can go in here, improve detail, put detailed hand, and now I'm gonna go ahead and generate and run that again. I'm going to go ahead and stop that. So for our purposes, I think we can show that that hand looks much better than it did before. Now you may have to do a few of these to get things to blend in better. Some of these blended in better than others. Yeah, so it does take a little bit of trial and error, but that's really what you want to do first. So after I got that to that point, so if I was happy with one of these, then I would go ahead and at this point continue and go back to the standard in paint, out paint, and continue to generate now to fix that hand. Okay, so I'm going to actually stop that now because one of these actually looks pretty good. See, the problem is with this one is getting the hands at the side is I find very difficult for the AI when it has a side angle. So that can be a big challenge sometimes when getting good results. So this one here, it actually turned the hand and it had an easier time of generating that hand. Yeah, that one would probably be workable, but I'm going to actually use this one here. So we have, let's look at that one. Now, this one here, where it's pretty close, I'm actually going to try the improved detail first. Let's see, and see if that can do enough with it before I go through the process of trying to inpaint certain areas of that hand, because when you're doing small areas, it can be a little bit harder for the AI to actually do as good of a job. Okay, and as we can see here, this one's actually making it worse. So I'm gonna stop this one because I actually think this was probably one of the best results. So let me pull that one up. Okay, so on the original image we have on the left, and on the right we have the finished image. Now, I picked an extremely difficult one, and I would probably have to go through and touch this up a little bit in something like either Photoshop, GIMP, or something like that, because with the rain, it did make it a little bit easier to see where I inpainted it a little bit. So that's something to keep aware of. But overall, I'd say these came out pretty good compared to what they originally looked like to what the final looks like. Now, I would normally at that point, depending on what I'm going to do with this, I would export, you know, save it, bring it into Photoshop, and just, you know, tweak those a little bit more to get the results that I wanted. So, but that gives you an idea of the process I go through. First is to use the regular inpainting and outpainting until you get a decently structured hand. It may not be exactly perfect, but it has the right number of fingers. It doesn't have a weird shape. They're not distorted or anything like that. Then you can go and switch it over to the improved detail, put in a detailed hand, and have it finish up from there. Now, like I said, it depends on a lot of different factors. I picked a really difficult subject because with the rain and everything, that made it a little bit harder, I feel, and for it to actually correct that. But hopefully that gives you some tips on how you can do the hands. Like I said, there's no perfect solution. So this is just another example of one I did earlier. And as you can see, the one on the left had some messed up hands. And then the one on the right is after I've gone ahead and improved the hands. And as we can see, if we really zoom in, this one did a pretty good job with the inpainting. You can't really easily tell. Now it's trying to add the drops of water. So the rain was definitely makes it a little more challenging, which is why I went with it. It didn't blend this in perfectly. So I would probably go back and GIMP or something like that just to touch it up. So sadly, there's no perfect solution yet to AI hands. And until the models are trained on higher quality images, I don't think there'll be an easy solution. Hopefully this helps you fix those bad AI hands. And if you found the video helpful, please do hit the like button. Thanks for watching and have a great day.